Hey everybody, welcome to Rock and Pop Vinyls. This is episode 18. I hope everyone had a fantastic weekend and may the 4th be with you. That was yesterday, but continuing with that theme, I've got a little Star Wars decorations going on here with Mr. Vader and Stormtrooper. And it was a great weekend. I will share a little bit of that with you in a little bit, especially when we go into our Out in the Wild segment. But with that said, we are going to start off like we always do with the vinyl of this episode. So we are in the Bees, and we are moving on to Blink 182, the pop punk sensation that they are. This album is Take Off Your Pants and Jacket, very clever, fun artwork. This album came out in 2001. I do own their entire collection in either digital format or CD, but I actually only own two albums on vinyl, this one being their 2001 effort and their latest, their 2016 effort, California. This band really holds a very special place in my heart. This band came out when I was still in high school. I was actually on my way out of high school. And they came out with an album in 1993, which is actually considered by the band themselves their first album, which was called Buddha. But their actual official album, first album, came out in 1995, that record being Cheshire Cat. They followed that up with their third record, which would be Dude Ranch. And Dude Ranch was the album that really put them on the map, got them radio play. People were starting to turn their heads a bit. And then finally, they released their album in 1999, which was Enema of the State. Enema of the State shot them into ultimate stardom, stratosphere. This is the follow-up album. This is my favorite record still by Blink-182. It was just a lot of fun. I kind of like my punk rock to be more traditional punk rock. I'm a big NoFX fan, Pennywise, Face to Face, even Strung Out, even though they kind of, that band actually has gotten better musically over the years to, they almost borderline metal actually. But that's my punk rock. But this is fun punk rock. This is just goofy. I mean, this band is known as, you know, throughout history of their history anyway, for just being big goofballs on stage, a lot of toilet humor. Matter of fact, their material, their latest record, California, which obviously we'll talk about in the next episode, is actually more to their roots. They had a couple releases. They had a self-titled record, which came out after this album, and then they went on hiatus for about a good 4 years. But even with that hiatus, they didn't produce an album for at least another 4 years. So it was about an eight-year break between the self-titled record, and they gave us an album called Neighborhoods, I believe it was Neighborhoods. And the album was very lackluster. It brought back a very bitter Tom DeLonge, from what I understand. He went on to form Angels and Airways, and he got pretty experimental with his sound, and which is great. I mean, music's subjective, so you can do whatever you want. I mean, this is probably no one's favorite album, but there was a lot of hits off this record. This was an MTV darling, and I just don't know why. It just really registered with me, and it's easily my favorite record by this band. But anyway, like I said, they released Neighborhoods, which just very lackluster record, and Tom DeLonge ended up actually finally leaving the band. In enters Matt Skiba. I hope I said that right. Maybe it's Matt Skiba from Alkaline Trio. That infused a little more of that old school Blink that made him famous onto the album California, and I really, really, really enjoy that record. It'll be fun to spin that next week. But anyway, that's where we are with, here we are with Blink-182 with Take Off Your Pants and Jacket. Yeah, I got that queued up, and we'll go ahead and get started on that. All right, there we go. Well, anyway, this weekend, of course, I knew there was going to be a lot of things going on. There was also Free Comic Book Day yesterday. That was happening all over the valley and across country. And then, of course, May the 4th. And with that said, I went out shopping, had a great Out in the Wild. I didn't spend a lot of money this week. I mean, I really went overboard last week, and I brought that up in last week's episode. I said there was no way anything I did this week would match what I did last week. So I did spend a little bit, and I'll show you all that after the, my Out in the Wild segment that I want to show you, because I had such a blast yesterday. Went out in the wild. I went to a place here in Phoenix called Collector's Marketplace. First time there. I've heard nothing but glowing things about this place. I just haven't had time to really get out there and check it out. I finally took the time, went out there, and I'll tell you what. I fell in love with the place. I could have stayed there all day and filmed and talked to people, meet people. It was just a really cool celebration of just pops and action figures and pop culture and just this geek overload. It was such a fun place. So anyway, with that said, we're going to go ahead and go right into Out in the Wild. Alright guys, it is Saturday, May 4th, May the 4th be with you, and this is the Out in the Wild for episode 18. We're at Collector's Marketplace in Phoenix, Arizona, and they're having a Funko Pop event that they have once a month, and we're going to go check it on out. So here we go. All right, guys, so we're at Collector's Marketplace in Phoenix, Arizona. And let me tell you, this is a nerd's wet dream. I didn't want to say it that way, but it is. It is absolutely fantastic. It would take me literally 3 episodes to cover the coolness of this place. But what we are going to do is we're going to first focus on their pop event that they do twice a month. And we're going to go from there. And if I get a little more adventurous, we're going to go ahead and just check out this entire shop. But here we are at their pop event. We're going to get going here. This is like Chase Wall. Oh, look at this Red Hulk right here. That is fantastic. I'm telling you, folks, I'm going to walk out of here with a very, very light pocketbook. There's a lot of real great vendors out here, and hopefully what I'll be able to do is I'll meet a lot of them, and we'll go ahead and I'll give them a link onto this channel so you can check out their collections if they have them online, or actually come out here to Collector's Marketplace in Phoenix. Like I said, this is done twice a month, and yeah, get on out here and check this out. This is fantastic. You're free Dutch brothers, man.
I think the last bit that I have is going to be where
Oh, here we go. I'm sure if any of you have been watching, you've already seen quite a few grails that have popped up on this already. I've already caught quite a few. Oh, check out this Buzz Lightyear. There we go. How often do you guys see that one?
Freddie Mariachi guy. Yeah. I got 2. I'm waiting for the TJ one to drop, dude. I'm getting that. He does. I'm pretty sure it's Jack Skellington in a costume.
That's exactly what I said. Exactly what I said.
That's how you got
Chris
on the
H-Rock. You know, my model costume.
I'll send you a picture. So this is pretty much Grail Central, as you can tell on this wall here.
She really liked
that. Yeah, she this is a who's who of Grails. Oh, here we go. Check out this Lino, Mumra.
What's wrong with you?
Yeah, I'm going to call this little section right here the Grail Wall.
You got one? Yeah,
amazing.
T-shirts in a row. Remember the bag.
So like I said, this event happens twice a month here at the Collector's Marketplace in Phoenix. Look it up. I'm sure you can find them online. They're also on YouTube and also Facebook. And these vendors come out twice a month to celebrate pretty much everything pops.
Must be like 3 days of madness. Contact up here.
Oh, this is
I bought it and the person who wanted to buy the real one. They did like 4 banks.
Okay, so that was actually just a small room of all the pops that they have back there. They actually have an entire section in the back of the building as well. And I'm heading out there right now. I'm trying to avoid going into the rest of the shop because I feel that I'm going to end up losing a lot of money in the process. But we're going to go find the side of this building and check out the rest of the vendors in this place. And we'll maybe take a gander through the rest of this wonderful shop.
All right.
Okay, so it's just fitting that with it being May the 4th, that we talk about this Star Wars wall. Okay, folks, you have got to come out here. This is fantastic. I think I had every single one of these figures when I was a child. Of course, some of them I blew up, some of them I froze, some of them I buried in various parts of my backyard in Los Angeles. They're probably still there. I actually probably still have a couple of these in mint condition, still boxed in my collection somewhere out in the garage. Little Gwen in the background. Sorry about that, Gwen, but you'll serve purpose here. We got these hanging ships everywhere in here. Oh, check that out. Luke Skywalker versus the Wampa. We got ourselves some Black Series here. I know a lot of you YouTubers out there are big into the Black Series. I see that a lot on your channels. This is probably one of the better collections I've seen anywhere in store. Oh, check these out. Like I said, I could literally be in here all day. I'll check out these TIE fighters up here. Oh my. This isn't even half of the Star Wars collection that's in here right now, so... Oh boy. I have to come back here at a later date and get this is gonna be another episode in itself. And here we have a total Harry Potter universe. This entire section. I should start a list of pops that people need. Get a list and I'll come down here every single weekend and just start buying up for people and sending them out to you all. This shop is probably boasting the largest pop collection in, I would have to say, in Arizona, hands down. This is the largest concentration of Funko Pops I've ever seen anywhere. You got a lot of good horror pops. There's Hellboy. The new movie was not very good. Just my opinion. Now this is the kind of case I need for my loose ones. Oh, this is great. Here's a nice NFL section. This looks like the entire wall of video game pops. I do not collect a lot of these. A lot of them accidentally end up into my collection via mystery box. But for those out there who really like video game pops, there's an entire wall out here as well. And now I found a DC section. Of course, being the big DC fan I am, I literally have everything that is here. Does that make me a hoarder? I'm not sure, but I do have a lot of these. And then we got a bunch of Marvels down below. With Ezekiel Elliott. Must think he's a superhero because he slid his way into this Marvel section. Of course, if he had a show, it'd probably be better than Iron Fist. So, just saying. Oh, this is a really cool Captain Marvel mask. I may actually have to pick that one up. I have the regular one. Oh, there's a couple of them back there. Okay. That should be easy to do. And of course, going with the theme of May 4th, we have an entire Star Wars section. I think the Star Wars universe, when it comes to pops, is never ending. Very hard one to keep up with. That's where I'm at the point with these, that I have decided to collect only what's near and dear to my heart. And if I pick up anything else on accident. Of course, if I ever see another one of these again, I could do without. have four of those now, thanks to mystery boxes. So, yeah, I'm actually going to just start giving those away. All right, and then we got a movie section. This is probably my favorite to collect. I just love my movie pops. A few more video game ones here. Some more Star Wars. And here we are with Big Mike. I think I do a little bit better of an impression of Big Mike. But here we are, we got a whole horror section. I was walking around looking everywhere to find this. So I found it. This is my playground right here. Check out these Jasons. Big old 18-inch ones. I remember when those came out. Bunch of McFarlane's Movie Maniacs. I have that entire series. I actually own like 10 Michael Myers from that series, all mint condition. Matter of fact, they're all 10 plus graded. But I have a little bit of an obsession with Michael Myers. That's okay. Could be worse obsessions. Look at these movie monsters. You got Dracula, Dr. Heck, Mr. Janaid, The Mummy, Wolfman, Bride of Chucky. We can go on and on. This is great. I don't think I want to leave. I think I'm just going to go ahead and film here all the time. Again, like I said, this is a collector's marketplace in Phoenix. Check out these Pan's Labyrinth. Mr. Walter White. Judge Dredd. Oh, those are hilarious. Guys, so I'm leaving the collector's marketplace on this real sunny Saturday here out in Phoenix. Let me tell you what, that is the coolest shop in Phoenix. I don't care, bar none. I'll take the Pepsi challenge on that any day of the week. They are open 7 days a week. You can find them online. And I'm coming back. I'm definitely going to do a Go Figure segment here. They have figures like you would not believe. This mission this time was just to showcase their twice a month pop event that they do here at the collector's marketplace, and worth every penny. I did get a couple of items, and I'll share those back at the studio just because my hands are full and I don't want to film and do that at the same time. But yeah, so definitely get on out here if you ever can. Check them out online, and I can't say enough about this place. So collector's marketplace. Hey guys, welcome back. I hope you really enjoyed my out in the wild this week. That is definitely a spot, the collector's marketplace, that I would really like to visit at least on a monthly. They do that pop event twice a month, so I'd really like to get out there, film some of the people that are selling the pops, maybe network with them and introduce them to you and see if there's ways where you can order pops from them. I noticed several of them out there had everything from just email contacts, Facebook pages. I connected with one person out there, had a great conversation with her, and I'm going to hold off on giving any information out right away with her just because I wanted to make sure I have permission and all that stuff. But I really want to network her. I thought she was really fun. I actually ended up buying a pop from her. I finally was able to finish off my Beetlejuice collection, but she had this Only at Go glow-in-the-dark Beetlejuice. I have the regular edition of the Cab Driver Beetlejuice. but I really, or tour guide, Beetlejuice actually say, reminds me of like a cab driver, that kind of hat, but it's more like the tour guide. But I had the regular one, I really wanted this one, and she was really cool. She had it at PPG price, no big deal at all. I saw it, had it in a nice saw protector. They had a great spread, they had a lot of great pops, and this event was great. I mean, I really want to showcase it more, and time willing, and everyone else there, if they want to get on here, I'm going to do that. I didn't spend a lot of money. I was really watching my pocketbook. Like I said, last week was crazy. I spent so much money, so I'm trying to build up a little fundage here, but I ended up picking up that because I really wanted that, and I actually ordered this a couple weeks ago. I got it in the mail. It was completely crushed. I mean, destroyed beyond repair. I actually couldn't even salvage the box like I did on previous episodes about trying to salvage and save the pop, but I couldn't do it. So he's just back here loose somewhere. I don't even have that stand protector that I ordered last week for just putting out this. He's back there hanging out. I called the guy I bought him from on eBay, and it's just one of those things. I'm not going to go into negativity, but pretty much I'm stuck with it, and that's all there is to it. Suck it up, so I did. So it was really cool to find that, and I wasn't going to walk out without it. And I have been on a big mystery mini kick lately. At first, I had nothing against these at all. They're cool. I see the funness to them. But I didn't realize how really cool and detailed these are. But I found this Friday the 13th Hot Topic exclusive. Now, I know this was part of a box, but they had this loose taken from that collector's box, and it was out for sale, and it wasn't big. I think it was like $7.99, and it's Jason Voorhees with the potato sack burlap, like the sack mask that he wore in the original, and actually the second movie, technically. It was the second movie. But, and I really wanted it. I still actually want that entire box set, and that box set actually has a plush Beetlejuice, which would go perfect with my collection, and it has a Leatherface, and it has this, but I'm really attracted to these right now, and that will actually play up a little more in this episode. Matter of fact, I'm dedicating this entire episode to mystery minis. This isn't a mystery mini, so I didn't really want to open it. It tells you exactly what it is, but we do have some mystery minis that I did get in a mail call, and some that I picked up, and so we'll cover that in a bit. But next up, we're going to go ahead and do our mail call. Guys, welcome back, and we do have a mail call. So we're going to start off with, I actually have several from Hot Topic this week. This one, I believe I received this on Wednesday, and I know which one this should be because I went ahead and did a reorder on it. I don't remember, I think it was like, I want to say 4 episodes ago. I ended up with a Beetlejuice that I wanted to him in his tux, in the wedding tux, and it was completely damaged. I called about it with Hot Topic, and they weren't willing to cooperate at all whatsoever, so I went ahead and boxed him up, and I sent him back. Matter of fact, I sent him back 2 weeks ago. I still have yet to receive a refund. Maybe I'll follow through, but I don't know, but I went ahead and reordered him. So that's what this box is. So let's cross our fingers and make sure it's not part two of a damaged Beetlejuice, because that really pissed me off. But anyway, I'm still a little bitter about, I'm not even bitter about the fact that it was damaged. I'm bitter at the customer service aspect of it. That was ridiculous. I mean, the girl wouldn't even listen to me at all, at all. She's like, no, you're stuck with it. We don't guarantee pop boxes. She's like, as long as the pop is okay. Cool. Thanks. Spending hundreds and thousands, actually thousands of dollars a year I spend at Hot Topic. That is not a lot. At least be nice. That's all you gotta do. Be nice. Just say, hey, listen, our policy is cool. Don't be a jerk about it. Anyway, so I sent it back. Still have yet to get a refund. But I really want this pop. I just really do. I didn't even use any hot cash, nothing. I just straight up ordered it, $12.50, came to like $15 with shipping. I really want this pop, and I want one in good condition. So here we are. The box is in decent shape. We're in a sorter. The sorter looks pretty good. Everyone inspecting with me. We look fairly good here. So let's hope and pray. I'm really praying because I really don't want to do this again. I really like this pop a lot. All right, we're looking good. We have a good condition. It's all I want. Matter of fact, on this pop alone, they now have darn near 30, almost 32 of my dollars with tax and shipping and all that for this pop. And this pop isn't worth that much. Matter of fact, I've paid more. I mean, I think right now on the PPG, this pop's worth $11 as of this morning. But I really like it that much. But thank you, Hot Topic, for sending me a good condition. Beetlejuice. I'm kind of falling out of love with Hot Topic right now. Even though I did go on there today, and you know, today is the last day of your hot cash, folks. So if you got any hot cash, get on there. It's a great deal. Buy $30 worth of product of any sort, but I, you know, I'm going to spend it on pops, and you'll get $15 off your hot cash. Last day to use it. Next time you can use your hot cash with Hot Topic. It's going to be in July. So start saving those up again. So anyway, here we are. Good shape. We have our Beetlejuice. All right, so we have another Hot Topic, and to be honest with you, I don't know what this is. I order so much, and I'm sure a lot of you out there are in the same predicament as I am. You just forget. I mean, I keep track, don't get me wrong, but I also work, you know, 80 hours a week, and sometimes I'll order these things on the fly if I see them. I order a lot of my stuff. I order very early in the morning. I'm talking like 4 a.m., you know, because I'm usually 4 a.m. is where I'm having a little bit of coffee, and right before I go to work, I start work every day at like 4:30. So it's really cool because it's the whole early bird gets the worm type of situation. I've been very lucky. So anyway, but in that process, I do forget what I've ordered. I've got a few of these coupons. I'm going to cover up the code though, because I think they're pretty cool. They're $15 off 50. That's kind of a cool interim coupon, I think. Even though the hot cash program is better, it's drawn out, and you only can use the hot cash in a week time frame when they have it allotted on your hot cash coupon. But this has more of a, like, this is actually good until the end of May, and so I would use this on more of, say, like the new Disney box set that came out with Aladdin and the Snake. I really want that. That box set is $32.90. Chances are I'm going to buy two pops that go with it anyway. I really want to buy the Chris Hemsworth character. I don't even have their characters' names memorized. I think it's Agent M and Agent H. I want to buy his character from, and the leading lady's character who plays Valkyrie in Avengers, and of course Thor Ragnarok. I want to get both those characters, so I was thinking maybe like the Aladdin with the Snake at $32.90, those pops coming in at about $12.50 starting probably tomorrow. They'll go back down to the three pops for $27. So I might get three of those and the Aladdin. I'll definitely take it over to the $50 mark, but it'll knock $15 off. Can make it worth it. So that's a decent coupon. It really is. And like I said, in the interim for hot cash. Look at this. Here we got our return exchanges. I won't call anymore. I'll just do this from now on. I don't even know how long it takes to get your return. I'm still waiting on my money from my last Beetlejuice. Okay. So last week, I told you that I actually ordered this. This is the Tim Burton, Michael Keaton, 1989 Batman. I ordered this about 3-4 days before I actually found it last Sunday at Box Lunch on the shelf. I have a tendency to double up on my Batman anyway, so it was no big deal to me, and I love this pop. I love everything about it. I love it is down to Batman, even the Batman logo in the original in the 89 Batman, had kind of like a weird bottom bat tail, and they nailed it down to that, to even the belt. I mean, it was really cool. So here we are in this order. I'm very fortunate because I already know that I do have one in good condition that I got from Box Lunch. I picked off the shelf myself. But let's see what we have here. Other than a little box dust, this looks... All right, this looks great. This looks fantastic. We're in good shape. This is such a sharp Batman. I love everything about it. The box, I was in eighth grade when this movie came out, and I was in line with my Batman shirt on. I had a hat with a Batman pin on it. I was like, just, and this movie came out, this is how bad I even remember, came out on June 23rd, 1989. I live in Arizona. If you know what June 23rd in Arizona, but anyway, it was horrible. It was about 115 degrees outside. I was standing in line to see this in a single screen movie theater that only showed one movie release every other week. And of course, that movie happened to be Batman, and brings back a lot of great memories. So I'm really excited that I have two really good... See the big smile on my face? I'm a big freaking dork. That's what I am. But I love myself. It's okay. Someone needs to. Alright, so we're going to continue this mail call. We have a last one here. Sorry, Stormtrooper. Could help a little bit. Okay, so we have one more from Hot Topic. This one's bigger because I did order... this is 4 pops. Oh, it's a mixed bag and my memory's failing me. I think it might be a couple that I'm missing from Toy Story 4 line. I wanted to get the Hot Topic exclusive of Buzz Lightyear. He should be in here. Here's my packing slip. So this should be Buzz Lightyear. Okay, cool. This will be a fun one to... Let's just hope and pray. We got 4. I'm taking a big risk here. Alright, so here we are. Return to the... Oh, got another one of those coupons. So now I got 2. They're just trying to get more money. Hey, as long as they keep on delivering good... That's all. I need Hot Topic to get back to that. Okay, all 4 of these are in sorters. Oh, cool. Okay. Okay, again, sorter looks good. We have no vents. No. Alright, so, anyway. Alright. So this is a Hot Topic exclusive for the new Spider-Man Far From Home. We have Mysterio without helmet, and we are in excellent condition. This is a really cool pop. A lot of detail. Jake Gyllenhaal is playing this character in the movie. I'm really excited about this movie. The closer it gets, the goofier it looks. I mean, I'm not proud. Matter of fact, it's bored. You know, I don't know. We'll see. I think there's a lot more going on in this movie than we've seen in the trailer that may even goof it down some. It looks like 3 possible enemies. I'm also reading between the lines. I'm seeing 2 enemies that are actually probably created by him. They're an illusion. Don't read into what I'm just a big dork. But anyway, that's a cool pop nonetheless. Mysterio, great shape. Big smile. All right, we're doing good. And I have more sorters that I can save for shipping. Hey, if you guys remember, I still do have a... I do have a Ronin from Avengers. If anyone did not get him, let me know. I'm only asking PPG and shipping. So, like I said, I'm not a flipper. I'm not one of those guys. And I'll help you guys out. I only bought him on the fly. So, alright, so next up is a Hot Topic exclusive Sheriff Woody from the new Toy Story 4. And we look like we're in really good condition, and the Hot Topic exclusive has Woody holding Forky, so that's fun. All right, so great condition. great condition. All right, so let's go for number four. All right, this one's got a little damage to the sorter, but it's only here in the edge, so we'll see. And hopefully this one's going to be... Oh, yes, I'm excited about this. This is going to be one of those ones where I'm probably going to order a couple if I can get them, just to have them, just because he just seems lonely. But we have our Toy Story 4 Alien. And let me check here. Okay, I thought I felt like a bulge or something, but no, he looks in really good shape. We have no warping, no lines. The display glass is good. Okay, so there's our Alien. He's actually pretty much, at least here in the Phoenix market, he's pretty much dried up. I don't know if that's happened to everyone else, if maybe in smaller markets, if he's still easy to get. I don't know. Let me know. Give me some feedback, because I actually want to try to get at least two more of him. Even on HotTopic.com, he wasn't on their list this morning. I was looking. I'll look again. If he is, it's great. Maybe I'll incorporate that into my 50 with my $15 off. We'll see. So far, we're 3 for 4. We're in great shape. Our last one here is... Okay, cool. So here we are, and he looks in great shape. Spider-Man in his hero suit for, number 468 from Spider-Man Far From Home. I have so many Spider-Man now, it's ridiculous, but I love it. I love Spider-Man, one of my favorite Marvel characters ever. But yeah, all right, we're in great shape. So we are, there we are. We are 4 for 4 for Hot Topic. Well, actually, technically 6 for 6, because I was only counting this box. So the Batman and the Beetlejuice came in great shape. So, so far, so good on this mail call. I did have a surprise, and I'll get into that in just a second here. Let me go ahead and even these out, because I'm running out of space. I have two more packages I need to do here. I had two deliveries from Target, and I'll show you which one was a surprise here in a second if I can hold on to my boxes. But here we go. So this is from Target. Okay, I know what this is. Okay, remember last week when I got the Target exclusive, or the 2019 Galactic Convention, or what was it, Galactic Convention exclusive, the gold chrome Stormtrooper? Well, he showed up damaged. And, of course, I told you Target's really good about replacing them or giving you very quick options to get them back. They issued me a number immediately online to return my damaged Stormtrooper. So I went ahead and sent that back, and they sent me a new one within 2 days. So the shipping was extremely quick. Unlike the Hot Topic incident I had to deal with the customer service, this was the direct opposite. Very, yes, sir, thank you, sir, yes, ma'am, thank you, ma'am. Very along those lines. How can we help you? How can we make the situation right? Matter of fact, they offered to refund me my money immediately. I don't want my money back. I spent the money for a reason. I want the pop. And I explained that. I said, no, I want a pop that's not damaged. And they were like, hey, that's great. We get it. That's cool. I'm not there to scam anybody or like that. But I also have a certain expectation of my collectibles. I'm a collector. I want them in good shape. That's all there is to it. And when I did that unboxing last week, you all saw it was in a box just like this. Came with an outer box. Came with a box in a box, which we love. And it was wrapped in bubble wrap. I'm probably going to expect a lot here. I'm just going to hope I don't have a repeat of last week, because that really caught me off guard, really, after all that. So here we are. We're in the same situation, exact same situation. We'll see. I'm kind of nervous, because I'm starting to wonder if this bubble wrap they put inside is doing the damage. But, this one's definitely in better shape than the one that I sent back. Yeah, there's a lot of bending. I'm starting to wonder if I'm going to win with this. I don't know. Maybe you guys. What do you think? Do you think this type of bubble wrap, as you can tell, I mean, it's very sturdy. I mean, this would be great for glass or something like that. But the way they send it wrapped like this, and they jam pack it into that box. And I'm wondering if just the nature of shipping and the force of blowing into that box, that this bubble wrap causes it to concave. Like, the last one was completely bent. The side was blown out on the side. But this is this glass is completely bent. I don't know if you can see that. It's at an angle. This is at an angle. There was even a little lip right here. And, you know, I'm nitpicky, but I'm allowed. It's my money. I should be nitpicky. I'm probably just going to roll with this one and keep it as is. I mean, I can't beat a dead horse, but I honestly think it is this wrap. What do you guys think? Let me know what you think. Let me know down below, really. I mean, I'd love to hear it. I love the feedback. And but anyway, he's almost there. He's almost there. So I'm just going to go ahead and accept that as is, and I'm just going to roll with it. Okay, so now I'm really kind of worried because the next box is my Target box, and my second Target box this week. Now, this one I'm excited about. Yesterday morning, I got up, and here it was, May the 4th, and May the 4th be with you. Excited, Star Wars Day. But I also knew that Target was launching a chrome red Darth Vader. I got up immediately in the morning, had my coffee, got online, ordered two, because that's how bad I want this pop. That was yesterday morning. It is here today. I got a nice mailman ringing at my doorbell. Well, it was some kind of courier. It wasn't the mailman because it's Sunday. But I was surprised. I was actually expecting I ordered a new shelf for some of my pops that was supposed to get here today. And it did get here eventually from Amazon. That's what I thought the doorbell was. But nope, it was Target. And I was like, well, I don't have anything else coming from Target. So I went on, jumped on my phone real quick, looked into my account. And up in the top, had my little Target little insignia at the top of my phone, and I opened that, and it says, hey, your Darth Vaders were delivered. I ordered this yesterday morning, and it's here. It's a really big box for two pops, so I'm pretty much guaranteed it's going to be a box in a box. I'm excited, but after that stormtrooper, I'm really worried. Maybe I'll luck out, and I'll go 50-50, and one of them is not damaged, and one of them is fine, or I mean, one of them's damaged, one of them's not, but yeah, it's exactly that. So these are obviously, they're pre-packaging these. They got these in here not to let the boxes move around. Got mine just for you, thank you, from them. But here we are, two single boxes, which means these are going to be wrapped in that same bubble wrap that we just saw with the Stormtrooper. I'm just going to hope that the outcome is not the same. Pardonnez-moi, may I take a drink of my beverage? Okay. So, yeah. Two. Red Chrome, Darth Vader's. This is a Target exclusive. They made this exclusive to just red card bearers. But okay, now see, this one has that bubble wrap, but it's different. They did a single sheet. It's not wrapped. And then they put two bottom. Actually, what they did is they put a little air pack bubble in here. They put a single layer bubble wrap. They have that same single layer at the bottom. I can see right now this pop is not, just right now, I could tell it's not damaged at all. All right, there we are. This is our Target exclusive Red Chrome Darth Vader. Looking mighty nice. So I got a 50-50 shot here that they're both in great shape. But there we are, Red Chrome. And that was their, like I said, it was an exclusive they made to their red card holders. find a friend that's a red card holder, come order, or talk to me. I have two of them. Let's hope they're both okay. So here goes number two. And same exact situation. They're doing the single layer on top, followed by a small air packet to keep it from moving and shuffling. And they do have the bottom layer of this same exact. And it looks like number two is in good shape as well. So here we are. Red chrome Darth Vader. Number two. Right there. All right. So, all in all, other than the little misshapening of the gold chrome, like I said, I'm not going to go after them. I was really excited to get the Beetlejuice in great shape. And all the other pops, the two Spider-Man and the two from Toy Story came out great. And, of course, don't forget my favorite superhero of all time, Batman. I now have two fantastic ones of that. All right. So that is the mail call for this week. I'm going to get this all cleaned up, and we're going to return with, I don't have a Go Figure this week. That became part of the budget cuts for this episode, but I am venturing into our mystery minis, and I'm going to do a whole little thing on that. I got quite a few that I want to open and talk about. So anyway, let me get this cleaned up, and I'll be right back. Welcome back. I got that entire mail call cleaned up. That was a lot of pops. And I was telling you that I was going to spend a lot of money this past week for this episode, but sometimes I don't take those mail calls into account. That was six, eight pops. Lost count already. But anyway. Well, anyway, I'm on a new little adventure here with the Funko Mystery Minis. I've always liked these. I mean, I don't have a loathing disposition with these like I do, say, Dorbs. Very anti-Dorbs, can't do it. There's not one Dorb out there I want. I do have a few exceptions in my collection. There was the, again, the 89 Batman Tim Burton Batmobile Dorb. I had to have it. I mean, that movie's near and dear to my heart. No matter, in retrospect, how goofy that movie is now, it's still, it's just a classic. I love that movie. Anyway, a lot of good memories. But I bought that. That's one of the exceptions to the rule. And Taylor, a couple years ago, bought me a Gamora for Christmas. Just saying, she bought me a Gamora for Christmas. Anyway, so that's in my collections. But I really like these. I haven't delved into them. I have a whole bunch, actually, that are single varietal mystery minis, which means there's no mystery about them at all when they're just single varietals, because they come usually in a box set, like your Legions of Collectors or your Smuggler's Bounty or your Marvel Collector boxes. You get exactly what the box shows. They showed you this earlier. I bought this at Collector's Marketplace, so I know exactly what this is. I don't have an overwhelming itch to open it. I do have a plan. I really do. You know, obviously you have to open the mystery minis to find out what you have, to find out if you have any value or not. But I have a plan. I want to do a really big, like, display, almost like a fish tank, like one of those big 50-gallon fish tanks, and just do a total, like, village type display with these minis. You know, they're really cool, but I'm kind of, you know, fighting the itch to open this, but we'll see. Anyway, so I picked up a couple this week. I was at Barnes & Noble, and I picked up a couple from, of course, Avengers Endgame, and it tells you on the back who comes in these sets, and also tells you the probability of, you know, how hard it is to get whoever on here. For instance, the top row, you have Iron Man, Captain America, Hulk, and Thor. All three of these, you have a 1-in-6 shot at getting. So that's pretty good. Chances are, one of those four are in here. On this second tier, we have an Ant-Man. We have Captain Marvel. We have Ronan. And then we also have, third row here, we have Thanos, Black Widow, Oh, I've already forgot her name. So anyway, there's a few on here. Anyway, the hardest one to get on here is going to be War Machine right here. He's a 1 in 72 chance. And the Thanos actually isn't too bad. He's 1 in 12. We also have a 1 in 24 chance at getting this Black Widow. I have two of those. And we're going to go ahead and open them up and see what our chances are here. I'd be stoked to get that Ronin. That Ronin's really awesome looking. But so these are the two that I ended up getting from Barnes & Noble. I ended up getting two more from Walmart. Now, Walmart has the same set, except for the difference is there is three exclusives that you have a chance to get that only Walmart carries. You have a Black Widow in a different stance. There's a 1 in 24 chance. You have this exclusive Hulk right here. It's a 1 in 72 chance. Very similar to the... Very similar to the War Machine on this one. And then there is a Ronin or... Is it Ronin? Yeah, it's Ronin. There's a 1 in 72 chance of getting Ronin in this. There's an exclusive Ronin for here. It's actually Hawkeye, so it's Ronin without his mask, so it's technically Hawkeye. But there's a 1 in 72 chance of getting him. Now, that particular Hawkeye, I don't know if you can see it that well right there, he is already up to 150 on the PPG today. I was blown away for a mystery mini. He's worth $150 already. I didn't know these things had grail status. But okay, so we're going to go ahead and we're going to open the ones that I purchased from Barnes & Noble. This feels really weird to me opening a toy because I'm such a collector. But I was kind of inspired. I was watching Popcorn with Flicks Sunday, and Dwayne on there, he had opened a horror mystery mini, and it was actually gifted to him by one of the fans of their show, and I was really looking at it, and I was like, wow, the detail on that, and I believe it was Jason Voorhees, not like this, but in the traditional hockey mask, and it just had a lot of cool detail. There was blood on the axe, and there was bones, so I was like, you know what, I'm going to give this more of a shot. So so here we are. They come in the black bags. It's even more of a mystery. And that's why I have my trusty scissors here. So let's cross our fingers and see who we get. Aha! It was 1 in 12. It's not a huge thing. But we have Thanos. He's awesome looking. Oh, I love him. Wow, these things are really detailed. Look at the gauntlet. See right there? Oh, that's fun. Okay. I didn't realize they were bobbleheads just like their pop counterparts. That's pretty cool. That's fun. I don't know if these reclose or not. I'll have to experiment with that. Okay, so we have Thanos right out the gate. That's pretty good. I'll take that 1 in 12 shot. And we'll get this one open here in a second. Operator error. Whoops. Don't try that at home. Okay. There we go. The best I could do on the ones that I purchased from Barnes & Noble is I can get that War Machine, which is a 1 in 72 chance. We'll see. I kind of miss when Pops, when they were doing the chase figures, like 1 in 36. That made the hunt so much more fun. And of course, you know how I feel about the hunt. I'm a collector. It's the greatest part of doing this. It's the hunt. Now most chases are 1 in 6. Not hard to do. Alright, so we're here in the black wrapper again. Open it just like a bag of chips. I don't need my stinking scissors for that. Oh, this is fitting. Hopefully no no spoilers, but considering the ending of Endgame, got Iron Man. He is so fun. Check that out. The whole bottom, the flames, he's flying off in the air. Epic battle. That's pretty awesome. It's pretty awesome. They're much smaller than Pops, so you can't really... I have a lot of good ideas about displaying these, so... Alright, so let's go ahead and cut into our Walmarts. I got the Walmart insignia on top, so there's probably a good chance that I'd love to get the Hawkeye, the 1-in-72. Like I said, he... $150 this morning on the PPG. Wow, for this little guy. Alright, so here we are. We're opening the Walmart one. These are really fun. I'm really glad I decided to kind of dive into these a little bit more. But this is just another addiction. Seriously, that's just one more thing that I'm going to spend money on. I really don't need that, but oh well. Oh, this is actually fitting too. This is perfect. Got Captain Marvel. She's cool looking. What was her chances? I think she was, she was 1 in 12. 1 in 12. Just like, so Iron Man was 1 in 6, 1 in 12 for her, 1 in 12 for Thanos. Alright, here we go. We're shooting for, highly doubtful, but we're still shooting for that Hawkeye, man. Who would have thunk it? Grails in the mystery minis. But, okay, so here we are. It's hard to guess these, you know. You think you could kind of shake them around and guess by weight, but we'll see. Oh, okay. So I have my first repeat, and we have Thanos again. So I now have two Thanoses. So I don't know what I'm going to do with that, but all right, cool. So I have two Thanoses. This one's neck's kind of bent a little bit. Let's see if I can bend that. I don't know. Maybe he's stuck like that. Alright, so we have two Thanoses, and not really disappointed with that, but I was really hoping for, by his weight, I could tell he was heavier than the rest, and the only possibility in that Walmart package would have been the 172 Hulk. So I was kind of hoping for that too, because he's got the same probability as the Hawkeye. But yeah, these are fun. So this is my first foray into really going into the mystery minis. Yeah, I like it. There's not much into salvaging the boxes or anything, so I'm in total alien territory. I can't even tell you the last time I actually opened a toy willingly. Alright, so we have, even though this is technically a mailbox, I knew what this is. I know what this is. I purchased this from Amazon a few days ago. Still inspired by the mystery minis. And actually, Amazon's a really good place to find mystery minis if you're looking for ones that are no longer on the market. They have a pretty extensive collection on there, as does eBay. But the eBay, of course, their prices fluctuate big time, where Amazon was more on point the whole time. So these here are, it's three of them I ordered. I was I was inspired earlier by when I was watching Popcorn and Flicks with Dwayne opening some of his he opened that Gifted horror pop, so I not pop but mystery minis. It'll take me a minute to stop saying that. So I ordered three horror classics here. And you don't know what they are. Let's see what the possible probabilities are. It looks like the hardest one to get is from American Psycho. Christian Bale's character, I believe. I can't even remember his name. Wasn't it Bateman or something like that. Anyway, he's a 1 in 72. The next roughest to get would be the twins, the Grady twins from The Shining. They're 1 in 36, followed by Jason Voorhees at 124. Linda Blair's character from The Exorcist is 1 in 36. Oh, we got a 1 in 72. We have 1 in 72 with Freddy Krueger with the syringe fingers. So that looks to be the heavy hitter here. So the 1 in 72 for a 1 in 72 shot at Freddy Krueger or the Christian Bale character from American Psycho. So all three of these are in the same situation. So all right, we're just gonna go ahead and get into these and let's hope for Freddy Krueger. That would be freaking awesome. I just didn't realize. I mean, I always like looking at these things. I thought they were cool, but to me, they were slightly novelty. But then again, what is Pops? They are definitely novelty. So, okay, so I've got. I can't even guess. If I had to guess by. I feel a weapon. Uh-oh. This could be. Oh, okay. So here we go. We got Jack Nicholson from The Shining. He was a 1 in 12 shot. Man, he's awesome looking, though. Way cool. I was right about the weapon part. Oh, yeah. That's sad that I'm getting all excited about a figure about this big, but I love The Shining. Love Stephen King. I actually love all things horror. So that's just a fun. I'm really, you know, this is actually considered Series 3. I don't know, did they ever make a Michael Myers for this? I'm going to have to really investigate that because Michael Myers is my number one pretty much anything when it comes to slasher flick. Over everybody. Over Jason. Over Freddy. Nothing. In my eyes, he can destroy those guys. But again, it's all subjective, right? So, there's people out there that love Jason. There's people out there that love Freddy. I get it. It's cool. But to me, Big Mike is what started it all. And Big Mike's worth that. Okay, let's see if I can guess what this is. This is pretty profile. I'm not feeling a weapon of any sort. Arms feel like they're tucked in. This feels like it might be Elvira. Elvira's a 1 in 6 shot, so it's not a... Oh, look at that. Pegged it. Elvira it is. She's cool looking. I love Elvira. Grew up watching her. Remember on KTLA in Los Angeles, she was on all the time when I was a kid. She's awesome. All right. Alright, that's good. Now number 3. Now I want to open my Jason. I think I'm going to just open my Friday the 13th exclusive there. Because, I mean, I know what it is, but it's so fitting to go along with all these horror classics. I'm definitely going to pick up some more of these. This is fun. This is a lot of fun. Okay, so here's our last one. Okay, this one has a hat. Its hands don't feel like they're raised. I'm really hoping for that Freddy Krueger with syringe fingers. This is a one, I'm telling you right now, this is from A Clockwork Orange. Which is cool. But man, I'd love that Freddy with the syringe fingers. And, yep, it is Clockwork Orange. Just like a, oh man, he's kind of creepy. That's awesome. Look at the makeup around his eye. And then his cufflinks with the eyeballs on it. These are extremely detailed. Alright, that. Hey, I'm happy with all of them. I really am. I mean, I'm definitely going to get a few more of these. I'm going to shoot for that, that elusive Freddy. That 1 in 72 and that American Psycho. So, you know what? Might as well keep with the theme. We're going to go ahead and open up the Hot Topic exclusive, Friday the 13th, Jason Voorhees here. And just like that, I'm 8 deep on these minis. Now, I have more of these actually back up here in the cover that vary from the last Spider-Man movie. I have several Star Wars. I have a Darth Maul back there. So those will all have to come out of their packaging now. I'm already, a monster has been created. So here we are. We have our Jason Voorhees. And there he is. So we got a pretty good start on my horror mystery minis here. I'm really excited about that. So, all right, cool. That is fantastic. Well, to be honest with you, this is probably going to be one of the shorter episodes I do. I'm trying to get back to trimming it down a little bit just because I've been spending a lot of money. But it happens. It's the nature of this business. And in 2 weeks, I'm going to have an explosion again of some sort because there's a lot more pops coming out. There's, remember, when I was at Collector's Marketplace, they really were already had a bunch of our main places completely beat to the punch on pops. They had the new Simpsons pops already out on the floor. They had the Addams Family pops out on the floor. They had a limited edition, it's 20,000. I mean, that's pretty broad, but they had a Constantine pop that was released for Comic Book Day. And I almost picked him up. I was really, really close. But he was $24.99. That's not that bad, really, for a 20,000, I guess, run. But I can't even tell you, trying to pick up from last week's adventures, trying to keep up. So we're down to minis right now, just to fill that gap. But anyway. Thanks for watching this episode 18, and I hope to see you guys next week with our more adventures and out in the wild. And, yeah, so thank you for watching. We'll see you guys next time. Bye.